Hi there! Welcome back to Mommy and Daddy Kids. Today we have a story called Stand Tall Molly Lou Melon, written by Patty Lovell. Click that subscribe button for more stories. Let's have a look. Molly Lou Melon stood just taller than her dog and was the shortest girl in the first grade. She didn't mind. Her grandma had told her, "Walk as proudly as you can, and the world will look up to you." So she did. Molly Lou Melon had boxes that stuck out so far. She could stack pennies on them. She didn't mind. Her grandma had told her, "Smile big, and the world will smile right alongside you." So she did. Molly Lou Melon had a voice that sounded like a bullfrog being squeezed by a boa constrictor. She didn't mind. Her grandma had told her, "Sing out clear and strong, and the world will cry tears of joy." So she did. Molly Lou Melon was often fumble-fingered. She didn't mind. Her grandma had told her, "Believe in yourself, and the world will believe in you too." So she did. Then Molly Lou Melon moved to a new town. She had to say goodbye to her grandma and all of her friends and start in a new school. On the first day of school, Ronald Durkin called her "Shrimpo" in gym class. When the game started, Molly Lou Melon caught the football, ran under the legs of Ronald Durkin, and scored a touchdown. All the children thought, "Wow, she's good," and Ronald Durkin felt very foolish. On the second day of school, Ronald Durkin called her "Bucky Tooth Beaver." Molly Lou Melon took out her pennies, stacked 10 high on her teeth, and smiled as big as day. All the children smiled with glee, and Ronald Durkin felt very foolish. On the third day of school, Ronald Durkin said, "You sound like a sick dog. Honk, honk." Molly Lou Melon sang out a quack so clear and strong that it made Ronald Durkin somersault backwards, hit his head, and have to go to the nurse. All the children cried with joy to be free of Ronald Durkin for the rest of the afternoon, and Ronald Durkin felt very foolish. On the fourth day of school, Ronald Durkin said that she'd made the snowflake all wrong. But Molly Lou Melon opened up her paper and revealed the most beautiful snowflake of all. All the children oohed and awed, even Ronald. On the fifth day of school, Ronald Durkin brought Molly Lou Melon a stacking penny for her tooth and smiled at her. That night, Molly Lou Melon took out a pencil and paper and wrote a letter to her grandma. "Dear Grandma, I wanted to tell you that everything you told me was exactly right. Love, Molly Lou Melon." Hope you enjoy Stand Tall Molly Lou Melon. If you did, give us a like and subscribe, and leave us a comment and tell us about your feeling. We take care now. See you back here soon. Bye-bye.